The bar graph below shows the percentage of students who received each letter grade on their last English paper. The class contains 30 students. What number of students earn an A on their paper? So looking at the bar graph, specifically at bar A, notice how 30% of the students received an A. So to determine the number of students that earn an A on their paper, we want to answer the question, what is 30% of the number of students, which is 30? So what is 30% of 30? If we can answer this question, we know how many students earned an A. Whenever we're trying to determine the percent of a number, the quickest, easiest way is to convert the percent to a decimal and multiply. So 30% as a decimal would be 0.30. Of course, we can drop the zero here in the hundredths and just write it as 0.3. So we'd have 0.3 times 30. This product would give us 30% of 30. Let's go ahead and find this, and then we'll also set this up using a percent equation. And hopefully we do recognize this product would be 9, but just in case, we have 0.3 times 30, which is equal to 9. So 9 students earn an A on their paper. Using a percent equation to solve this, we use these key words to help set up the equation, where is means equals, of means multiplication or times, and what or what number represents the unknown, so we write down the variable. So looking at our basic question here, notice how the first word is what, and therefore we write down the variable or the unknown. Let's use n for the number of students. Next we have is, which means equals. And then we have 30% expressed as a decimal would be 0.3. The word of means multiply, so we have 0.3 times, and then we have the number 30. So notice how this product is the same product we have here, and therefore we know n equals 9. But as the percent questions get more challenging, the percent equation can be very helpful.